Dr. Lawson, thank you ever so much for joining us this morning. Even more importantly, flying in all the way from the Western Cape to join us this morning. We really, really appreciate it. Now, you are a radiologist.
Yes.
Obviously, you'll get involved in perhaps investigation of fibroids that Dr. Pakwe has so eloquently explained in the inset, where you might have to do a sonar to see it, to identify where it is. First, to confirm that it is there. Number two, to check exactly where it is situated and its size, because all those factors will be critical in how you are going to manage it. Of course, including the symptoms and the future priority of the patient. But how else do you get involved in management of fibroids as a radiologist?
Dr. Vicker, thank you very much for having me on your show. Dr. Ponto, it's very nice to be right next to you. This will be a very interesting discussion. I'm a radiologist who has trained in a subspecialty branch called interventional radiology. So I speak with two hats. On the one side, it is the diagnosis of fibroids, often something preliminary made by the gynecologist because the patient has attended first to a general practitioner and then he's referred it to the gynecologist, and the gynecologist has done various evaluations and assessments and it determined that the patient has fibroids. Now, as Dr. Ponton mentioned, the patient may end up in the diagnostic radiology suite where a sonographer or radiologist would repeat an ultrasound and identify certain factors about the fibroid, how big they are, where they are there any things associated with the fibroid? For example, are there lesions on the ovary? Are there cysts on the ovary? Are there infections in the pelvis? Now, sometimes in diagnostic radiology, we can offer an MRI scan, which Dr. Ponto spoke about. And one thing, particularly in our South African climate, the name Bonitas on the wall there tells it as well, you have to be cautious of cost. So MRIs are generally fairly expensive, and some people are able to fund them out of their pocket, some medical aids fund them.
Magnetic resonance imaging.
Magnetic resonance imaging.
Oh, yeah.
It is a fantastic form of investigation. It gives us incredible detail about the fibroids, about the uterus, about any problems.
So it goes better than the sonar or the ultrasound. It gives a little bit more detail.
It is the Rolls-Royce of imaging.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, it comes with a Rolls-Royce cost.
Mm.
So, you know, this is a fairly open discussion. An ultrasound will set you back, give or take, 600 or 800 rand. An MRI will cost 10 times that.
Mm.
Now that's very important for both the patient, the healthcare provider, and the medical aid, because someone has to pay for that.
Mm.
And you have to decide, how is it going to change your management? Now, many gynecologists will operate based on the findings of an ultrasound, and many interventionalists will continue doing the intervention based on the finding of an ultrasound. So the MRI is useful in some cases, and maybe a little bit later we can talk about something very similar to fibroids called adenomyosis. We'll see this in a slightly older patient, but we'll talk about that in a second.